In this video, we will be discussing about the organophosphate poisoning. These are the objectives of my lecture. Right by the end of this lecture, we all must be cleared with these concepts. That is the background of organophosphate, mechanism of the toxicity, how clinically patients have organophosphate present, how it is diagnosed, how it is treated, and what are the complications of organophosphate. Initially, the organophosphates were used as the insecticides. But in Second World War, they were used as the chemical weapons in the form of nerve gas agents. They are also used in the field of medicine to treat various diseases in various forms, such as the myasthenia gravis, Alzheimer's disease, Parkinsonism, and the schistosomiasis. Organophosphate is actually the chemical compound that is formed whenever an alcohol is reacted with the phosphoric acid. The resulting product is known as the organophosphate. To understand the mechanism of the toxicity of organophosphate, I would like all of you to recall the basic physiological concepts of acetylcholine release and its inactivation. This is a presynaptic neuron and this is a postsynaptic neuron. The space in between them is known as the synaptic cleft. Once the presynaptic neuron is stimulated, it releases the acetylcholine in the synaptic cleft. And that acetylcholine communicates with the postsynaptic neuron by combining with the acetylcholine receptor. So once the postsynaptic neuron is stimulated, it results in the stimulation of the effector organ, and that effector organ brings the required action by the body. And once that required action by the body is achieved, then as soon as it is possible for the body to eliminate or to remove the acetylcholine from the synaptic cleft, it does, either by reattacking it via the presynaptic neuron or by inactivating it via the acetylcholine esterase into its inert chemicals, that is the choline and the acetic acid. Now what happens? The organophosphates combine with this acetylcholine. Now this acetylcholine esterase is no more functional to hydrolyze the acetylcholine into choline and the acetic acid. So organophosphates actually inhibit the acetylcholine esterase enzyme. So what will happen? There will be the overaccumulation, there will be the overpopulation of acetylcholine at the synaptic level as well as where the receptors for the acetylcholine are present. So a clinical picture of hyperstimulated, hyperelevated, and long-lasting acetylcholine within the body is produced, known as the cholinergic syndrome. We know now this acetylcholine will show its effect by binding with the acetylcholine receptors. And those receptors are the muscarinic receptors and the nicotinic receptors. So cholinergic syndrome is actually the manifestation of the overexpression of nicotinic receptors and the muscarinic receptors. Muscarinic receptors are present at the postsynaptic neuron and the effector organ of the parasympathetic nervous system. So once the muscarinic receptors are stimulated, they will result into the stimulation of parasympathetic nervous system. And nicotinic receptors are present at the presynaptic neuron and the postsynaptic neuron of the both sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system, and as well as on the neuromuscular junction. So once the nicotinic receptors are stimulated, they would result into the stimulation of both the sympathetic nervous system as well as the parasympathetic nervous system. So cholinergic syndrome is actually the mixture of both the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system. But patient usually presents with the features of the parasympathetic nervous system stimulation because they are long lasting, while the sympathetic nerve stimulation is transient and that is not predominant as compared to the parasympathetic nervous stimulation. So to understand the clinical features of the organophosphate poisoning, we will be discussing what will happen if the muscarinic receptors are stimulated and what will happen if the nicotinic receptors are stimulated.